Thursday's Villanova, Thursday on CBS, killer among the wedding guests with mystery event. Harper's Island, it premieres this Thursday on CBS after CSI on the North Watch Network. 6 on Answer to North Carolina. Reynolds, that's got influence. And that Carolina defense. They close in on the shooters in a hurry.
They've really done a nice job of that, Jim. Challenging the jump shot without fouling.
3 out of 21 from three for Villanova.
And Villanova has not helped its cause by taking some contested early jump shots without moving the defense or the ball. That's his shot. And he overshot that one. Now see if Villanova can get something in transition.
And coming in, gets the layup. Gets right between Lawson and Frazier. They do it, Clark. I mean, here we are approaching midway second half. How can they come back?
Well, they've got to defend and come up with turnovers, Jim, and then you've got to be able to push it ahead and get some easy ones. They've really struggled shooting the ball from the perimeter. They've not been able to defensive rebound effectively. So Carolina has been able to get second shot opportunities. And unlike Villanova, when North Carolina has had a chance to knock down the three in a timely fashion. The Tigers have done it, Villanova has not.
That foul, Frazier, his second. You know, this is the 70-year anniversary of the first Final Four. There have been so many people who have contributed to the growth and the evolution of this great event. And one, well, we lost this past year, since last year's gathering in San Antonio. David Kaywood passed away last July, the age of 64. He was very instrumental in the management of media and his presentation of the Final Four for over 20 years, and very much missed here at this year's Final Four in Detroit, but remembered by all. And Deion Thompson and Ed Davis, you see Davis coming in for Thompson. Hands goes underneath. Hansel now has a double-double. That was his 10th rebound. Foul outside first. I don't know how he finds these little openings, these
tiny seams.
I'll tell you exactly how he does it. Is it footwork or what is it?
It's a combination of things. One, he's got rush hour handle. In other words, he can dribble in rush hour traffic. Bodies all around him. He's got tremendous strength. So you can't push him off the ball. Then his balance is outstanding. So all of that allows him to get into tight crevices and not get bumped off stride and find a way to get the ball up on the rim.
Well, Austin hits the free throw here. 5-10 on the night, and I know this is usually something that, you know, the strong suit for him, as you mentioned. Remember that, was it 50-48. You saw that last year with Jackson reception. Many have wondered about, maybe it is an issue. Who knows? It's about 55 yards, if you want, the nearest point of a backdrop behind the glass for a shooter. I mean, could that be part of the story here for going over?
I don't think so. I mean, North Carolina's made half of their 3-point shot. So, I mean, they're shooting in the same building. I think it's more the defense, Carolina. There's another time shot around and out. I think it's more the defense and the shot selection of Villanova than it is the depth perception.
James Clark will send Lawson back to the line. What do you see out of Lawson tonight?
Everything we've come accustomed to seeing from him. Taking what's available, picking his spots, and producing at a high rate of efficiency. You know, he had, coming into this game, he had 20 in the three-point game he played. 20 of the two-point.
You're a coach, you're like a 10-to-1 ratio. Unbelievable.
I mean, his career since the turnover is approaching 3-to-1. High 2, 2.6, 2.7,
which is fantastic.
Outstanding off the chart. Especially because he's got the ball all the time. Well, that's what you call a high-level custodian. He can put everything in his chair and know that it's going to get where it should be taken.
That was the fourth foul on Clark, so he coach now.